Let's talk about finding formula weight and molar mass. So all the information that we need comes from the periodic table. For example, for lithium, we have the atomic number of 3 followed by the elemental symbol followed by the average atomic mass of the element. And so the weight that we need, the weights of the atoms, are going to be this number. And however many significant figures that our periodic table gives us, we want to use the maximum number of digits from that number to ensure that we have a proper number of significant figures to maintain the accuracy of the information in our problem. So always use as many as are listed in the table to prevent making those kinds of errors. Since formula weight and molar mass typically refer to compounds, we will try the example first, lithium hydroxide, the strong base. Okay, so lithium hydroxide is composed of 1 lithium, 1 oxygen, and 1 hydrogen that we must add together to get the formula weight and molar mass. For lithium, we take our 6.94 from the periodic table and we add it to 16.00 from the periodic table for hydrogen and 1.008 for oxygen and 1.008 for hydrogen. When we add those together, we get 23.948 rounded to 0.95 to account for the significant figures limited by the hundredths place of both lithium and oxygen. And so for formula weight, we would use units of atomic mass units, which would be lowercase u, or we could use the units of Daltons. Okay, they mean the same thing. So what that means is the average molecule of lithium hydroxide would weigh 23.95 if it's averaged together over all the different isotopes of the elements. Okay, so we add those together and get that number. Molar mass just means, usually abbreviated by capital M, molar mass takes that same number and says, well, 1 mole, or 6.022, however many sig figs you have, times 10 to the 23rd, molecules or formula units of lithium hydroxide, since it's an ionic compound, formula units, 23.95 grams of this substance in 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd formula units of that substance. So it's just referring to a large sample for molar mass as opposed to the average single molecule, how much it weighs, okay? And so adding these up is not bad. We're typically going to use the molar mass, all right, from now on, because it's the most useful to us to think about samples that we can measure in lab. However, we've got to beware of our additions, especially when it comes to polyatomic ions and the subscripts. We've got to know what we can do. So first, we've got to be good at naming sulfuric acid. We know is the acid that sulfate SO42- makes, and so it looks like this. So if we're adding up the molar mass of this, we need to account for 2 hydrogens, 1 sulfur, and 4 oxygens. Okay, and so we've got to be able to translate our subscripts and multiply those out to know how many atoms we have in sulfuric acid. And so we put that together, we get 2 times 1.008 from the periodic table, plus 32.06 for sulfur, and then 4 times 16.00 for oxygen. And we add all of those together, and we get 98. Multiply first, then add 98.08 to the correct number of significant figures, 98.08 grams of sulfuric acid per mole. Okay, for lead nitrate, we've got to know our naming rules again. Lead 2 nitrate means 2 charge on lead. Nitrate is NO3-, so minus plus 2, we get 2 nitrates and 1 lead. Okay, so we know how to do that already. And so we've got to break it down. 1 lead, 2 nitrogens. Okay, so we multiply through the parentheses. 2 times 1 for nitrogen, 2 times 3 for oxygen is 6 oxygen atoms per formula unit. And so when we look at the periodic table to add these up for the formula weight or molar mass, 207, and to be particular with the units, we can put those in every time, grams per mole, 2 times nitrogen, which is 14.01 grams per mole, plus oxygen, 6 times 16.00 grams per mole. When we add all of that together, after we multiply, we get 331.22 grams of lead nitrate, lead 2 nitrate per mole of lead 2 nitrate. Okay, so if we write everything out like we're going to need to do for the problems, we would write it out with full units shown.